We all remember the devastating earthquake that rocked Haiti 2 years ago. One of the heartbreaking aftershocks of that disaster was a cholera epidemic that claimed more than 3,000 lives by year's end. A renowned University of Maryland scientist recently headed up an international research team that explored the roots of that outbreak, asking why and how can we prevent it from happening again. For 2 years after the 2010 earthquake that devastated Haiti, the country also grappled with a second disaster, a deadly outbreak of cholera, widely believed to have originated from an Asian strain of bacteria that was spread by United Nations peacekeepers from Nepal. But this past August, an international team of researchers challenged that conclusion. The group, led by University of Maryland's world-renowned scientist Rita Colwell, found that two distinct strains of cholera bacteria existed, one native to Haiti and one from Asia.
We were able to obtain samples from 80 patients, and these were from all over the country. And we were able to show that in a significant fraction of them, the cholera bacteria that was presumed to have been brought in was not present. Instead, they were the naturally occurring cholera bacteria.
For Dr. Colwell, this was just the latest finding to buck prevailing cholera wisdom. More than 40 years ago, she transformed the world's understanding of this disease when she discovered that cholera-causing bacteria are found naturally in water. They attach to plankton in rivers, lakes, and oceans, and lie dormant until favorable conditions allow them to multiply to disease-causing levels.
In the studies, we showed that clearly it's an environmental bacterium. Now, that wasn't acceptable at the time because it was believed that it was only transmitted person to person. And it took about 20 years before it was actually accepted that it's a naturally occurring bacterium. Now it's in the textbooks.
Dr. Colwell built on her early findings to introduce new ways of predicting outbreaks of the disease with satellites and computers.
From studies I was doing here at the University of Maryland, it occurred to me that the relationship of the bacteria that caused cholera with plankton could be measured from outer space using satellites.
Dr. Colwell's research has shown that dangerous bacteria loom in bodies of water across the globe, including the Chesapeake Bay and other U.S. waters. Good water treatment in our country tends to prevent any issues, but safe drinking water in developing countries remains an extraordinary challenge. Dr. Colwell takes pride in perhaps her most basic discovery, that using folded cloth filters out bacteria carrying plankton.
If you filtered the plankton out, you could remove the bacteria by 99%.
Colwell then led a study in Bangladesh that showed cholera outbreaks were cut in half when women were simply trained to filter drinking water through a folded sari cloth. Today, Dr. Colwell and her team are using their knowledge of pathogens and the power of computational genomics to create fast new tests that promise to save many more lives.